then we will proceed with the lesson carbon and its compound. Today we are going to see structural isomers. If I have to explain you in a simple way, suppose there is a number 12. This number can be written as 2 into 6, 10 plus 2, 3 into 4, 24 divided by 2. Am I right? All the questions or all the forms give you the answer 12. So 12 can be represented in various forms. Similarly, a hydrocarbon, maybe alkane, alkene, alkyne, can be represented in various forms. The molecular formula means the actual number remains same. Means if I take C4 and if it is alkane, double plus 2, 10. This is called as molecular formula. It can be represented in various ways. That is structural isomers. Means you can write in straight chain or you can make branches. But structural isomers are possible only when you go with carbon number 4. For carbon 1, carbon 2 and carbon 3, there are no structural isomers. Okay. Now, why is it so? Let us see for carbon 1. We are studying about alkanes. Alkane, if you remember the general formula of alkane, CnH2n plus 2. Now, if there is only one carbon, so what structural formula I can have? Can I have anything different than this? No. If there are two carbons, can I have anything different than this? The carbon must have three hydrogen at any cost, and one carbon must be attached to another carbon. So, no other formation is possible. If I have three carbons, here also structural formula is not possible. You know how do we write in line form? From three carbon we can write this way. So this is carbon 1, carbon 2 and carbon 3. This is a short form to write propane. Now we are at carbon number 4. So the carbon number 4 is over here. Now here the carbon number 4 can be shown in this way. One more line. So carbon number 4. Can you do this way? See, you will understand here better. This is one method. 1, 2, 3, 4. Can I write like this? 1, 2, 3, 4. Yes, I can. Means I have attached this fourth carbon over 2. Isn't it a different structure? Yes, it is. Okay, so I get one isomer. How do I write? Carbon 1, carbon 2, carbon 3, and on carbon 2, one more carbon. So I got a branch. This is a straight line and this is branch. Now, do you remember C for carbon and C for car? Car has how many wheels? 4 wheels. So count 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. So these 4, wherever I have gone dash, what should I write? Hydrogen. This is called as structural isomer. Structural isomer means their molecular formula is same. What is the molecular formula? C4 and H10. Both have C4 and H10, but their structures are different. One is a straight line and one is a branched. Here is the branch. Okay. Is any other thing possible? Fine. If I keep this 4 over here, here is the 4. So, first structure and second structure is same. There isn't any difference. Instead of 3, 4, it is 1, 4. So, 4 butane, only one isomer, structural isomer is possible. Let us write it properly. This is the first structural triple isomer. First one, where all carbons are in one line and remaining are satisfied with hydrogen. This is our first form. 3, 4. In the second form, 1, 2, 3, and here is the okay, so for butane, we got two structures. C4H10, both formula is same, but their structure is different. Just observe it for few seconds. Now, which is the carbon who has 5 carbon in the compound? The compound is pentane, right? So, pentane, first we will write its structural formula. Then we will try to draw the structure. Pentane is the 5th member. C5H+2+12. Okay? Line form. So 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. This is a straight structure. Means done. Now this is structure number 1. Structure number 2. If you are not getting in this, you try to do over here. See, can I do like this? 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Is it possible? Do they look the same or they are different? They are different, isn't it? So, 1, 2, 3 are in one line and on second there are two carbons. Carbon 4, carbon 5. So, remaining will be with hydrogen. But the middle carbon is connected with 4 carbon, so it won't come with hydrogen. It will not have hydrogen. This is my structure number 2. Let us try third structure. Can I do like this? 1, 2, 3. Okay. And here is one branch. And here is one branch. Or instead of branch, I say 4 are in one line. 1, 2, 3, 4 are in one line and 5 is over here. So there is a branch. So see, 1, 2, 3 all are different. So let me draw 4 in one line. 1, 2, 3, 4 and branch on second. So remaining are hydrogen. Okay, so this fifth one, if it comes on first or if it comes on fourth, it will be just like first structure. Fifth one, on second and on third doesn't make much difference. Okay? So second and third, it's almost similar. Means see, if I draw it in this way, instead of second, I have taken third. It looks like mirror image of each other. It doesn't make much difference. It is almost same. So now how many structures did we get? Structural isomers. Everywhere formula is same. C5H12. But the structures are different. So how many did we get? We have got 3 structural isomers. Okay. So structural isomer, some properties will be different. Physical, chemical, few properties will be different because their structure is different. That's it. Means you make jam of mango, you make pickle of mango, or you may make chutney of mango. Taste will be different because you are using different ingredients, isn't it? So here actually they are made up of mango. Same thing they are made up of the the same number of carbon and hydrogen, only they are arranged in different way. Now, shall we try with hexane? Let us try with hexane. Structural isomerism begins from 3-4 carbon. Till 3 carbon, there isn't structural isomerism for alkanes. Now we will go for hexane, where there are 6 carbon, 6 double plus 2, 14. So the first of hexane, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 means 6 carbon in a straight line. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Right? 6. So remaining will be hydrogen. This is a straight line. Second one. You should try here. So 1, 2, 3. So I have shown two branches at a time. Now let me show, or we will go step by step. We'll take only one branch at a time. We'll take only one branch. Next, let us try for two branches. So only 4 are in one line. Now first 6 in one line, 5 in one line, and now 4 in one line. Okay. Now let us try the next way.